Hi, I'm Ed Hyland. This is Ash News TV, and I'm joined now by Kate Fitchum, who's going to give us some ideas what HVO is all about. Kate, welcome.
Thank you. Health Volunteers Overseas is an educational nonprofit group. We've been around for 27 years, and our mission is to provide teaching and training to health professionals in developing countries. And about 6 years ago, Ash came on as one of our sponsors, and we started to develop programs to train people at the sites in hematology issues. We use short-term assignments because we know a lot of our volunteers are still in active practice, and to get out of work for a longer period of time is difficult. So they go. We currently have three sites: Cambodia, which is a pediatric hospital. They are trying to get up to speed to be the first hospital in Cambodia to treat ALL. So it's been a long process getting them ready, and we hope by the end of 2015. The staff there will be trained sufficiently, and in 2016 they'll start treating patients. We have a project in Tanzania, which is associated with Muhimbili National Hospital in Dar es Salaam. So they have a big program. It's a huge national referral hospital. And they have a group of residents each year, 5-6 residents each year. And our volunteers go down and augment the training they get from their staff, who are just overwhelmed with their workload. So they go there again for 1 to 2 to 3 weeks at a time and focus on a particular issue that maybe they have an expertise in within the world of hematology.
And the third site?
Is in Uganda, Kampala, Uganda, at Malago Hospital, 1,600-bed national referral hospital. They have very few hematologists on staff, so they don't have the time to necessarily give as detailed attention to the residents, to the med students. So our volunteers will go. They do a lot of their training in what they call teachable moments, where they're going on ward rounds with the med students or residents. And as they're dealing with a patient, they use the condition of the patient, the issues of the patient, as a teaching opportunity for the students.
Yeah, I was going to ask, is this a classroom setting or is this hands-on work?
It's hands-on. I mean, our mission isn't to provide service, but obviously care of patients is provided as a teaching opportunity.
And again, you mentioned how you work it into people's schedules. How would you like to bring in the volunteers so that they can be most effective?
It takes a lot of advance work, so that we have to be in touch with the site to saying, you know, this expert is coming. He or she has a particular field within hematology. They might look, say, at their residency training program, and when are they doing a module on bone marrow transplant or whatever. And so they try and work our volunteers into part of their schedule so that that expertise can be well used. It's always a challenge, and probably the best trait we look for with our volunteers is flexibility, because everything could be set up and they could get there and, you know, something has changed in the scene at the time and they have to go with the flow and still find those ability to train.
And do you look for all levels of experience? I mean, residents to retired, let's say?
Since we are teaching and training focused, we want people who have finished their training, sometimes have years of clinical experience, but we also send, within hematology, we'll send final year fellows. We try and pair that fellow up with maybe one of our other experienced volunteers going, or have them work under the preceptorship of a local hematologist there. And it truly is an amazing experience for a fellow to do it. And we have found if someone does it during their training, they will keep doing this type of work throughout their career, you know, every couple years try and do it again. So we like to get them at that stage too, but obviously those with a lot of clinical experience also bring huge things to the site.
Chance to share your expertise and knowledge with the world.
Absolutely, absolutely. And the interesting thing, I've been doing this for a long time with the group, to see the change of technology adding another layer of how our volunteers can keep in touch with the site, because they can Skype in once a week and help them with things. The people at the site will send emails, even some slides of whatever their issue is, and our volunteers can, via email, you know, provide them the support that they need, you know, help them refine the diagnosis for this patient, give them the confidence, you know, to go forward with it. So it's really been interesting to see how the technology has really kept a stronger bond between our volunteers when they're not at the site and the people that they've trained.
Kate Fitchum, thanks so much for telling us about HVO.
So thank you.
This is Ash News TV.